Kamiko, you healed very quickly. How scared were you when you hurt yourself against Missouri, and how happy were you to get back?
I was
so
terrified because it kind of swelled up funny, and you know, J-Mo, so she, we went and got the doctor, but just putting in work, Jenny is the best, so I mean, I'm not completely 100% yet, but once my adrenaline gets going, I kind of forget that I hurt my ankle, so I just try to go out there and play best that I can.
How close are you to 100, like about what percentage?
I'm probably like a good 75, 80 some days. It just depends. The swelling, it kind of goes back and forth, but it's just a work in progress. We rehab probably 2-3 times a day. So.
You said you were terrified at first. I mean, were you thinking this might be it for the season at one?
No.
I mean, how serious did you think it was?
I guess I was more afraid because I knew we were going in to go to LSU and play LSU, and we haven't been there. We didn't go last year, so the kind of environment that it was in, and me being a senior, I was a little nervous, but like I said, working with Jenny, I knew I had a shot to go out there, so just kept my hopes up.
When did you realize you were good enough to go?
Probably Thursday around noon.
Okay, good.
We were doing exercises, and J-Mo just explained to me that she thinks I can go out there and play, and I mean, I trust her with my knee, so of course I'm going to trust her with my ankle.
How much did it hurt, you know, after games and then coming back on Sunday? Was it?
Pain, if only I could describe. I think it hurt more than my knee, honestly. But, I mean, I was in a boot. Like I said, I rehab 2-3 times a day. And once I get going, like I said, my adrenaline starts flowing, and I don't really notice it.
So are you wearing a boot when you're not on the,
yes,
not
sir.
Practicing right
I
now?
Yeah.
Your numbers right now across the board have been really good this year. I mean, what do you see is your most important role right now?
I think just filling in where we need it the most, and of course playing defense. You know, one thing that's been stressed to me since my freshman year was playing defense, and that kind of just trickles down and my offense starts going. But I kind of just try to fill in where we need it, whether it's rebounding. I focus on that. I focus on, you know, offense end. But at the end of the day, as long as I've locked somebody down, I think I'm doing what the team needs me to do.
Are you trying to fill in for Ariel, help Ariel at point?
I'm trying to help Ariel out, but I think I'm trying to help Bashar out more, like with rebounding and stuff. You know, Izzy's out, and that was a big factor to us. But, I mean, like I said, just try to fill in where the team needs me most.
Has that always been your type of game, being able to do a little bit of everything?
I think so, and I think the coaches think so. I think that's why they get on me a lot, because if I'm not doing one thing and I'm doing something else, they're still on me. So, you know, I just try, like I said, just try to go out there and do.
Now, Bashar used to be a major rival for
Clarkson.
So, you
yes,
to have
my senior year, her freshman year. Oh, we're not going to talk about it. But I am. I enjoy playing with Bashar, you know, and just having somebody back from home is a wonderful feeling, but she's come in, she's done a great job, and I hope she continues doing it, especially after I leave.
So are they playing you at off guard, wing? I mean, what are you coming in as?
Come in as a two, you know. If Rail needs a breather, I'll be the one. Sometimes I'm down there in the post with Tabor. I know you guys have seen, she's the five, I'm the four. But our versatility, you know, this year, I think helps out a lot. And us being in the post, but we can play the guard, and that means other post players have to come out to the three-point line, you know, to guard us. So, like I said, just wherever they need me, really, I just try to fill
it. How much are they playing you at one right now?
Enough. Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't really know to put like a number to or anything like that. But like I said, whenever Rail needs a breather, I play the one. But other than that, I'm always on the wing. I say Coach Law with the technique, but then Coach Elsie, she just gets on me and she makes me do it. And if I don't get it right, she tells me to go over and over and over again until I get it right. So, I mean, they both played a role in me and my defense, you know. Dean, he just encourages. That's why I love Dean, because they'll get on me and he'll come up and just say, hey, kid, you got it, you know, how Dean is. So, I mean, they all do their own little thing for me. So.
I doubt you pay attention to your stats, because your assist-to-turnover ratio is just off the charts right now.
Somebody's told me that, and, you know, I don't pay attention to my stats. But, I mean, my teammates are open. I'm going to throw them the ball. And I've always liked to play where, okay, if I see you going down the floor, I'm going to throw it. I'm going to stop at half court. And I'm just waiting for everybody to come back, you know. But I'm not big on stats at all.
You're very unselfish, but you can score from this team. You do realize that there are times out there they need you to score.
Yeah. Yes, and like with Izzy being out, you know, and Sierra's just now coming back into the flow of things, they would do a lot of scoring for us, so I just kind of try to step up in that aspect. But I'm not going to get away from passing my teammates the ball. I'm not going to get away from, you know, playing hardcore defense. So, I mean, everything's been working out for me lately, so can't complain.
What do you think is your biggest difference as a player? What do you think is the biggest way you've grown this last year?
Just getting more confident in myself and my offense and defense, and not being so frustrated. You know, some past couple of years I've been a little frustrated with myself, or, you know, I'm going up and down, getting into it with coaches a lot. And this year everything's just kind of coming together. So I think that's just the big thing, just everything coming together, me just being confident in myself.
You talk about the versatility of different positions that you guys have all had to get used to because of the injuries. Mm-hmm. How comfortable is everyone with all the different hats they've had to wear at this point?
I think at first Tabor and myself, we felt like freshmen at first, but I think with the new offense we brought in, our pass and cut thing, it keeps us in our positions at the wing, outside arc, whatever. So I think just the flow of how we've been playing and the new offenses we run and the confidence that the coaches instill in us, I think that's helped out tremendously. So.
Do you think that happened this weekend? I know you're from the mid-state. Did playing Vanderbilt give you an extra bit of motivation?
The game we just had with them at their place gives us enough motivation. It's an in-state rivalry, and they're a great team, and I know they're going to be up for the game, so that means we have to do the same. But us being at home kind of gives us an advantage, so I'm pretty excited. I am.
Talk about Vanderbilt a little bit and mm-hmm. what you think from them in the first meeting.
They're a team that never quits. They've always been that way, but I think now that they've gotten more experience, Fogey and Lister, is that her name? Yeah, Lister. They've gotten more experience. They got more confident, and it shows. And so just coming in, we know what to expect, and we just got to bring it.
I've always talked about the sense of urgency you're mm-hmm. playing with now. I mean, and was there anything different you did to get ready for this season, knowing it was your last go around? Or
I mean, that in itself played a big role, and I think with everybody getting hurt and us being short on the bench, that kind of opened my eyes. And I've had plenty of meetings with Holly. You know, she told me she needed to step up, be a leader, and I just kind of took it in, and I'm doing what I'm doing now. So.
Consistency has been an issue for you in the past. Mm-hmm. The way you've been able to string these games together this last couple weeks, mm-hmm. maybe you surprised yourself at all, or is that something you always knew you were capable of?
I knew I was capable of doing it. I just had a lot of things going on, the past couple of years. And like I said, frustration was a big thing. And this year, it's my last go around. They tell me come out here and play. I got confidence in myself now, so I'm just putting it all together before I leave.
What was it that took away that frustration, changed that? Was there anybody you talked to?
I every day, I think last semester, I went in and talked to Jolette and talked to Elsie. And, just Elsie being at Kentucky and knowing how I play, and Jolette watching, they instill a lot of confidence in me. And they just told me, go out here and play ball, play how I know how to play. And they let me do it. And when I screw up, they let me know. But at the end of the day, they let me play the game that I know how to play.
Just greeting the teammates and stuff when they're getting the starting lines are being announced. Is that just a part of your personality? Or
most definitely part of my personality. But when I was out with my knee, I didn't want to run through the tunnel. So I was like, well, I guess we can do our handshakes here because we do them at away games. Mm-hmm. And that's just something that I wanted to keep going. I mean, I don't think it should change just because I'm starting, So something I love doing. I love my teammates. I love our handshakes. I just enjoy it.
So when did that start, last season or how soon?
It started last season once I got hurt. Before then, we had to go in there. Yeah. And now I'm just like, nah, I think I'm going to stay out here and do our little thing, get them pumped up for the game, get them going. So